My name is Michelle Williams. I'm a healer and a dancer. I'm a Cancer Sun and a Pisces Moon. Some people would say I'm a little bit too emotional. One day, I met this really awesome older man named Tom. He gave me a book and it transformed me into an empowered leader. Sometimes I get afraid of using my voice, but I know it's for the greater good. Hello everyone! Welcome back to another YouTube video. If you love to read about healthy eating, and if you just love to learn about healthy eating, subscribe to this channel, click the bell icon so you don't miss any of my future videos. So in this video, I'm going to do a book haul. These books I did not buy. So how did I acquire such books? Well, if you don't know about
hoarding,
my boyfriend is decades older than I am, and he's a very interesting character. He has lived a very interesting life. So along the way, he's collected a lot of cool things, and he's collected them. He hasn't gotten rid of them.
He likes to collect books that has really good information. If he ever needs to access this information, if someone he knows needs to access this information.
He's got a lot of books.
I was looking for one book and I found like five new books that I'm
so
excited to read. The first book that I found
in the store of my boyfriend's hoarding house
is Macrobiotics in Oriental Medicine by Michio Kushi. Now, I've never read this book before. On the back it says, the theory, the application, the scope, and the conclusion. A handbook for personal growth, family health, and social well-being. So, if you guys didn't know, I'm really into this lifestyle called macrobiotics.
And I think you would like to learn about it too.
So the next book is Visions of a New World, The Era of Humanity by Michio Kushi. I believe this was lecture notes back in the time of Michio Kushi when he was teaching the world about yin and yang and healthy eating and curing yourself. He would speak his lectures, and this was before people were really video recording. So oftentimes there'd be somebody transcribing, you know, writing down what he was saying, and then later they typed it up and published it in like a small book form. So I feel like this is a lecture notes book because it says here, world government, cancer, political leadership, drug abuse, macrobiotic education, global hunger, natural motherhood, family roots, and land communities. And here on the side, it has some constellations. Yes, because in any given lecture, Michio would never say,
come on down, we're gonna be talking about natural motherhood at this lecture.
You would just hear, Michio's in town, he's giving a lecture, cool, let's go. And he would just talk. He was very jazz musician about it, so you kind of didn't know what you were gonna hear. A lot of the times he took questions from the audience, but sometimes he'd make the whole lecture based off of one person's question. So it was kind of cool and something I hope that I can do someday. So that's why in this one book, there's all these topics because, like I said, it was probably lecture notes transcribed. So you get like a whole bunch of little snippets in one thing. This is called Biological Transmutations, and this one is by Michelle Abicera. Michelle Abicera was another famous macrobiotic teacher back in the 60s, 70s. He studied with George Osawa. So if you guys don't know the story about macrobiotics, you can buy my macrobiotic zine issue 1. You can click the link to my Etsy shop to purchase it. And I talk about a little bit about the history of macrobiotics, who George Osawa was. I'm basically a French guy that was teaching macrobiotics. It says here, a new science practiced by MDs, chemists, biologists, and nutritionists. I'm guessing if you're more science-y minded, you might like this book. It seems like it was written for people like that. It says, if you need iron, take organic manganese. If you need calcium, take organic silica. The movement of life proceeds from the constant changing of one element into another. So he's like, you know, talking about macrobiotics, I guess, in a more science-y kind of way. So that might be good for some people out there. That's not really my style, but I know it's important for me to be able to speak to people who maybe jive better with that kind of thought pattern or language. And then this one has a really awesome cover. Again, it's by Michelle Abusera and Raymond Dextrit. It's called Our Earth, Our Cure. And this one is a handbook of natural medicine for today. So healing herbs, fruits and juices, vitamins and minerals, lotions, poultices, masks, pomades, spices, clay. So I'm thinking, it says it's up here, the macrobiotic approach to lifelong health. So I'm guessing this is not so much about the diet. It does talk about, I'm sure it talks about it a little bit about eating, but oh yeah, there's,
oh my gosh, people.
I just turned to this page. It says recipes for relief of constipation, and there's cookies, there's whole wheat plum cake, there's crackers, there's stuffed cucumber, spinach, aspic. Wow, this is kind of cool. I'm interested in this. And then this book is called Healing Harvest, Michio Kushi's Guide to Sustainable Home Gardening and Food Production. I'm so excited. One of my dreams is to have my own garden where I grow my own fruits and vegetables and flowers and herbs. So I'm really excited. I'm really, really excited. And then this last book is by Eric Lachaucer. It's called Love, Eric, Delicious Vegan Macrobiotic Desserts. The foreword is by Michio Kushi, and it has a little quote from Madonna. Yes, Madonna ate macrobiotic. Eric's macro desserts are so indulgent, you would never think they are sinful. Yeah, I'm excited. Ooh!
I'm really excited. I love desserts so much, people.
Like, people think I think it's my Virgo rising, why people think like that I don't eat like sweets or that I don't like sweets or something.
I love sweets.
I was the biggest cookie monster, sugar fiend, everything. That is why, oh my gosh, that is exactly why I'm so adamant about promoting this lifestyle, because it's like, I was the worst one.
I was the worst one.
And if I could change,
you can change.
For sure. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and let me know if you want to see more big book videos from me. Peace.
Need consciousness higher, higher, and higher, higher. And for that, you need good health and good way of eating. Food is not only nourishing body and so forth, food is nourishing also our consciousness, mind. Example, if you take alcohol, mind become like that. You're drunk, you become like that. Same thing, the meat, grains, or vegetables, the way of cooking, sugar and so forth. Everything, whatever you are taking, because those vegetables, grains, meat are energy.